Yes, listen. Hey, I am your host, Sister Vicky. I want to certainly welcome you to the Watch Out Podcast. I do believe that late in the midnight hour, God will certainly turn it around.
If you are the host, please enter your PIN file. Thank you. There is one other participant in the conference. Please announce yourself.
Hello, 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 hello. I want to welcome you to Watch Out Podcast. I am your host, Sister Vicky, and we're going to do midday prayer on today. Amen. Today is Wednesday, June the 23rd, and we're going to do midday prayer, amen, because we know that it's very important for us to pray at midnight hour and also midday hour, because when we pray midday hour, you know, it give us time to be ahead of the enemy to go ahead and command the rest of our day. Amen. So we can go ahead and cast down everything that Satan had for us. Amen. And that had is past tense. Amen. What he had for us. So we go ahead and pray on that thing. Satan has no legal right. Amen. In Jesus' name. If you could turn to your Bible, Psalms 23. And I'm going to be reading Psalms 23 in its entirety. While I read aloud, you read along with your eyes and your Bible. Amen. I'm going to be coming out of the NIV on today. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He made me lie down. I'm sorry. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you, God, are with me. Your rod and your staff that comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That was Psalms 23, verse 1 through 6. Please, on your devotional time with God, read through that and see what God give you out of that. Amen. Praise God. Father God, we thank you on this midday hour, God. We bind up every principality that would try to cause any distraction in the airways, that would try to confuse your people, that would try to keep your people from receiving your presence right now, Father God. And we counsel it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every destruction of the enemy that will try to come against our mind during prayer. Oh, Lord God, keep our mind stayed on you during prayer, Father God. Oh, Lord God, first of all, Lord God, we repent. We repent from past and present sins, Lord God. Everything that we have done, everything that we have said that wasn't pleasing in your sight, that didn't line up with your word, that didn't come together with your will. Father God, we say sorry. From a sorrowful place in our heart, we say sorry, Lord God. And God, we ask, we repent, and we ask for your forgiveness right now. Right now, Father God. Forgive us, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We receive your forgiveness right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we thank you for everything that you have done so far in the earth, Father. We thank you, Father God, for keeping your hands on us, oh God. Thank you for keeping your hands on our family. Thank you for keeping your hands on our friends, Father. Thank you, Father God, for not allowing the devil to steal, kill, and destroy us in the midst of serving you, oh God. Thank you, Father God, because he don't have no legal ground. He don't have no legal ground, oh God, to harm those that are in you, Father God. He has no legal right, no legal authority to bring children of God under. And Father God, we walk in our authority on this midday. On this midday hour, we walk in our authority, Father God. Oh God, we command blessings upon our household. We command peace upon our household. Some of us may be on our job, and we command peace on our job, Father God. Your great goodness and mercy shall follow us everywhere we go, oh Father. Your goodness and your mercy shall follow us, oh God. Oh God, we thank you. We thank you for your hedge of protection that you have around us, oh God. We thank you, oh God. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, oh God. We give thanks on to you on today, God, because we know that some people didn't make it to see this midday hour. Some people is not able to hear and not able to experience your presence right now, Father God. But Father God, we say thank you. God, we say thank you. We said thank you, oh God, for everything that you have done so far, Father. We thank you for opening up doors that Satan has been trying to shut. We thank you for shutting those evil doors that Satan has been trying to open, trying to get your people to walk through, oh God, when it's not your will. Thank you, God, for stopping us right in our tracks, oh God, not allowing us to move forward in Satan, Father God. Father God, we thank you, oh God. Oh God, we need, our households need a touch from you like never before, oh God. Certain people in our households are not saved. Certain people in our households need to be delivered. And God, we thank you. We thank you for your delivering hand. We thank you for your delivering power. We thank you for your resurrection power, Father God. Because God, you are able. You are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could ever imagine. God, we thank you. We thank you, Father God. We thank you, Father God. No, this life is not perfect, but you are perfect, Father. You are perfect, Father. And you are able to make crooked ways straight, oh God. Oh God, we're praying right now for people in our families, oh God, that are going through difficult. They are going through difficulties with their life, with their life, and with their bodies, with people around their relationships. Oh God, we're asking, oh God, that you cover people in our families, oh God, because Satan is trying to do everything that he can do to try to keep our family from serving you wholeheartedly. And God, you are calling people. You are calling people to serve you wholeheartedly. You are calling people like never before. And you are calling people in our families. Oh, Father God, I thank you. Oh, Father God, I thank you for your hands being upon my family, for the listeners' family. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you, oh, God, because you didn't allow the enemy to triumph over us, oh, God. Oh, God, we thank you right now for pulling our family members out of darkness and bringing them into your marvelous light. We got family members that are not saved. We got family members that are bound by sin. We got family members that are bound by demons and principalities. And, God, our family needs to be delivered. We are praying today on the behalf of our family. Oh, God, our family needs to be restored. Some of our family have cliques, oh, God, but it is not your will that we live in cliques. Our family, it's your will that we come together in unity. It is your will, Father God, that we be all that you have called us to be together. Amen. Together, amen. Together, amen. Oh, Father God, we thank you. We thank you on this midday hour, Father. We thank you on this midday hour, Father God. Oh, Lord God, we had a difficult week. Some of us had a difficult week on this week. Oh, God, we was facing many trials and tribulations. And we had so much going on around us, so much going on within us. And we just didn't know where to turn. We didn't know what to do. But, Father God, your hands be upon
Bluetooth
us.
Disconnected. Bluetooth. Pairing.
Amen.
Bluetooth. Connected.
Amen. Your hands been upon us. Your hands leading and guiding us through the day. And Father God, we command the rest of our day. And we say, Lord, touch us. Touch our family members like never before. Touch us in a mighty way, oh God. Oh God, every darts of the enemy shall be destroyed on today. We bind up every principality that would try to steal, kill, and destroy our happiness, try to kill and steal and destroy our health, try to kill, steal, and destroy the blessings that you have upon us, upon our lives, try to steal, kill, and destroy our spiritual journey. Oh, Father God, we come against those principalities that is trying to steal, kill, and destroy our relationship with others, and most importantly, our relationship with you. We bind up every work of the enemy. We counsel every work that has been designed to block, stop, and keep us from our God-given destiny. Oh, Lord, we have the authority through Jesus Christ our Lord. We have the authority to speak those things as if they were. We have the authority to walk in greatness. We have the authority in the mighty name of Jesus to bind up every work of the devil, to bind up every work that Satan has for us to harm us in any kind of way. We counsel every curse that has been spoken over our lives, that has been spoken over our family lives. We counsel every curse that has been sent our way by warlocks and witches and those that practice magic or arts. We counsel it. It shall not prevail over us in the mighty name of Jesus. We cast down every plan, plot, and scheme of Satan in the mighty name of Jesus. And we say, Lord, have your way with us on today. Have your way with us for the rest of the week. Have your way with us, oh God, like never before. Oh God, may we keep a repentant heart, God. May we keep a repentant heart, Father God. Because you know, Father God, that we try our hardest, oh God. You know, Father God, that we have a desire to endure to the end, Lord God. Search our hearts, Lord. And those of us that have wicked hearts, oh God, give us a clean heart, God. Give us a clean heart, Father God. Take out stony hearts, oh God, and give us heart of flesh, oh God, a heart that loves, a heart that cares, a heart that has compassion upon others, Lord. And Lord, we thank you on this midday hour. God, we say, have your way, oh God. Oh God, have your way like never before in the earth, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Is there anybody online on this midday hour that need prayer for anything? Amen. Because if you need prayer for anything, please speak now. Amen. Because this is the time to pray and to intercede and to command your day. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, with that being said, I want to thank each and every listener that's going to come across this video over YouTube. And I also want to thank each and every participant that has joined me on live on this midday hour. I want to say that next Saturday, we will not be live on the phone lines or Facebook. I'm using that time for my devotional communion with God. I need to sit down. Sometimes we come to a place where we have to sit down and we have to really get quiet and hear what God is trying to say to our spirit, and we have to get quiet. You know, sometimes prayer is not just praying and you're talking. Sometimes prayer is you just sitting quiet and listening to what the spirit is trying to say to your church. And that's what I'm planning on doing. So please, just because we're not going to be live, and because we're not going to be live on either platform, that does not mean you do not pray. Please continue to pray midday hour, and please don't let Saturday be the only night you pray midday hour. At least try to do it twice a week if you can. If you able, amen, or every day if necessary. Especially if you're going through a lot of warfare. If you're going through a lot of warfare and stuff, this is midnight time is the time to pray. Amen. You don't have to take my word for it. It's plenty of other people that can back me up on it on YouTube. If you just look up, you know, praying midnight hour or something like that. you know, Google it, you know. I mean, read the Bible, you know. It's right there, and it tells you, you know. Anytime, it doesn't matter if it's, you know, midday hour. I don't want to, you know, go out into details about it right now. I want to use another video for it, but most importantly, regardless of what time you pray, you need to pray consistently. You have to pray on a consistent basis, you know. And I'm telling you, like, every day, you need to make it a routine, you know. As you push yourself to pray, you continue to pray, even when you don't feel like praying. You know, sometimes all hell can break loose in your life, and you know, you don't feel it in you to pray. But that's the time that you need to pray. Amen. Like today, you know, I was going through so much and stuff like that. Just today itself, and it's just the midday hour now. And, you know, but I still made an effort to pray. I still made an effort to pray. And that's what you have to do. You know, sometimes it's going to be hard to pray. It's going to be hard to get it out. But you got to push yourself. Amen. You got to push yourself. But, you know, with that being said, we are going to have midday prayer the last Wednesday of this month. We will, you know, for the last, because we had midday prayer for the entire month of June. I want to thank each and every participant that has joined midday prayer thus far, that has came across this audio over YouTube and have listened to midday prayer. Amen. I thank God for you. Like I said before, please continue to pray. Please continue to develop a prayer life. Amen. And when you do that, you realize your burdens will be lifted. You know, your warfare. You know, if you're a child of God, you're going to always experience warfare. There's just, there's no way around it, you know. But most importantly, please, 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 get yourself in alignment with the will of God, because that's most important above all else, is getting yourself in alignment with what God wants and needs for you to do. All of us have a good work to accomplish here on the earth, and the only way we're going to be able to accomplish the work that God's had for us, we have to have a prayer life. We have to read his word, and we have to not be selfish but intercede for others. And I thank God for what he has done thus far in our lives so far. Amen. With that being said, I want to say y'all have a wonderful, wonderful midday out. Midday. Enjoy your midday. If you feel an urge to continue to pray for other things beyond what we have prayed for on the line on today, please do just that. Amen. Please do just that. And continue to send your petitions up to heaven and watch God pour you out the blessings you need to accomplish the will that he has for you to accomplish. And most importantly, tell somebody about Jesus Christ. Tell somebody about Jesus Christ. Spread the gospel everywhere you go. Amen. Spread the gospel everywhere you go, because the time is winding down like never before, and before we know it, Jesus Christ will be back for his church. And so the main thing is making sure that you're ready and making sure your family and friends is preparing and they're ready as well. Amen. So with that being said, I love you. God bless you. And y'all have a wonderful, wonderful weekend, weekday. And we will see you again June. I will see you. We will be back here again June 30th for midday prayer. And then we'll be back in the month of July back to our regular scheduling for midnight prayer. Thank you and God bless you.